Hi there, lovely people of the Shetland Islands. I was very much looking forward to coming and performing and teaching and visiting your community this summer. I've heard wonderful things about the Shetland Islands and somewhere that I've always wanted to go. And I was super excited to be going on that journey this year, but hopefully it will happen next year. Due to the current situation, I'm actually going to be performing my number here at the place that I'm staying. I'm actually from Australia, but I'm actually very, very far from home at the moment. I'm quarantined in Panama, of all places. I actually came here to work at a festival. I was invited, and during the festival was actually 2 weeks long, and it was in the jungle by the beach, and it had very little internet access. And during the festival is when this pandemic kicked off. So the first thing we heard about it was when the military showed up and quarantined us on site at the festival. So it was a very long festival. Eventually they did let us out though, and I actually drove to Panama from Mexico. So I had my car and my two dogs, and so we tried to get back up to the border, but unfortunately by the time we got close to the border, they'd already shut the borders and we weren't able to get across to Costa Rica, which would have been the first country on the way up to Panama. On the way up to Mexico. So here we are.
I was born in a thunderstorm. I grew up overnight. I played alone, I played on my own. I survived. Hey, I wanted everything I never had, like the love that comes with life. It took her to a place where all the demons go, where the wind don't change and nothing on the ground can ever grow. No hope, just lies, and you're taught to cry in your pillow. But I survived. In the strangest place, way in the back of my mind, I saw my life in a stranger's face, and it was mine. I had a one way ticket to a place where all the demons go, where the wind don't change and nothing on the ground can ever grow. No hope, just lies, and you're taught to cry in your pillow. But I survived. I'm still breathing. I'm still breathing. I'm still breathing. I'm still breathing. I'm alive. Possibly me, I took what you gave, but you never noticed that I was in vain. I knew what I wanted, I went on and got it, did all the things that you said that I wouldn't. Told you that I would never be forgotten. I know that's but you.
It's me again, Satya. I'm here to do a little workshop for you guys. I'm going to be teaching you a little bit of hula hooping. Now, I know that most people have given it a try before, and a lot of people have been left feeling like it wasn't for them. Well, I just want to let you know that everyone I've ever taught to hula hoop has successfully made a few rotations. So first of all, with the hula hoop, there's a few things that are really important in order to get it going. You want to make sure that the hoop is completely flat. Because a lot of people, they try to start hula hooping it like this on an angle. So already, it's not going to work. So you want to have the hoop completely flat to the ground. And think about just turning it from side to side, like this. Now with the hula hoop, you want to think about being in the center of the hoop and putting your body as forward and back. So you're hitting the hoop forwards and back. So the easiest way to do this is to actually put one foot in front of the other. And you want to actually, a lot of people think it's like this, but it's actually forwards and backwards. So you want to press the hula hoop up against your lower mid back. Give it a hit to one side, it doesn't matter which direction. You give it a push and then move the body back and forwards. And you want to think about keeping a rhythm. If your hoop is falling down, it means that you have not gone, you're not going fast enough. You're not maintaining the rhythm. And once you get a bit of a rhythm going, you can try and walk your feet closer together. If that's too difficult, don't worry, you can keep them apart and you can just shake it out however you like. Arms can be anywhere, anywhere you want. You can try turning in a circle in the same direction as the hoop, and if you've really mastered all of this, you can try turning in a circle in the other way from the hoop. The next step, once you've got this one going, if you want to get really tricky, is to look for the spaces in the hoop. You want to try and find the space. So there's a space. Because as your hoop is turning around you, there's this huge space here. And on the other side, huge space here. So as the hoop is turning, you want to look for the spaces. Because once you find those spaces, there are so many tricks you can do. But that's the first step, finding the spaces. Good luck, guys. Hey, guys, don't forget to send your circus postcards at hashtag circuspostcard. Thanks a lot, and see you soon. Hey, guys, I just want to say thanks for watching. I know it's super hard times at the moment. I mean, who would have thought that something like this would happen in our lifetimes? And yeah, I just want to say, everyone, stay strong. We're all still here. Keep breathing. And I really hope I get to see you all next year. Thanks.